As an individual ages, they believe that the negative consequences of aging are pretty much inevitable. However, simply not true. It's a myth. So many age-associated things that decline, the result of not necessarily of age, but the fact that they are being inactive. So today we've got a couple of special guests with us. Care coordinator for therapy services, Corey Walden. Also, Alice Haugen is a current resident over at Edgewood. So to both of you, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having us.
So you were just bragging right a moment ago about how you're doing a bunch of great activity, you're doing yoga. Tell us about it.
It's because of physical therapy. From extreme pain in my hip, I'm now able to participate in our exercise classes in yoga, and I'm intentionally walking each day. I have a routine that I follow in order to build my bone health.
Good for you. And so are you seeing that the pain in the hip is going away? Is it gone completely? Or?
Well, yes, I think so.
Wow.
Unless I do something crazy.
Unless you're out partying late some night or something like that. But I'm curious, how have you taken to the yoga?
I like it.
Yeah?
I do. And that night, I can sleep so much better. It's really relaxing. It is. And we don't do the floor yoga. Wouldn't be able to get up off the floor.
Oh. So
we do standing and sitting.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. Congratulations.
I'm glad of that. They come in and do that for us. Help
yeah.
us.
So talk a little more about the physical therapy that you guys are doing and how it's helping people.
So yeah, there's kind of a big stigma when it comes to the geriatric population and when it comes to therapy, in the fact that, you know, they think that it can't help them, or they just don't want to do it. And you know, when it comes to people like Alice, who they finally get into therapy for some pain management or for some balance control, they've been able to see great results, and then they want to keep coming back. So that's kind of just spreading the education again that, you know, we can help you, and maybe you just don't quite know yet, you know.
So what do you do with people that go and maybe don't see results right away, or they try it and like, oh, this isn't working, they get frustrated? How do you continue to help them move in that direction?
It's kind of, you know, educating them right away. It's therapy is not a quick process. Alice, you may know that. You know, we see you twice a week for maybe 8 weeks. So it's kind of just getting them to stick with the process and to really understand that we're not going to be able to take your pain away today. You know, it's going to be a long process. And hopefully we can help mitigate that along the way.
So what kept you coming back? Because, you know, sometimes it's easy to just say, oh, I'm not going to do that today. So what kept you coming back?
Oh, no. It was really encouraging because I was in extreme pain. From hardly being able to walk to now intentionally walking. I have a routine every day where I'm walking to improve my bone health. And I wouldn't have been able to do that without physical therapy.
Now, are you on a treadmill? Or are you walking through?
I don't like treadmills. I can't do it. So
yeah.
I walk. And we're fortunate in Edgewood Vistas where I live. It's really conducive to walking intentionally. We have two different patterns that we can walk.
Nice.
So glad for that. And also I wanted to say with physical therapy, we're never done with it. Now they have helped me with follow-up so that I am able to do all of that in my apartment. And they monitor that and also help me if I need any extra.
Oh, that's nice. You know,
yeah, and so, it's not, you're done.
So are you doing the yoga in your apartment too?
No.
So you're going down to the physical therapy room and doing that?
No, it's in a different room. In our exercise room, we have a person come in once a week and give that yoga class.
We've got a few seconds left. So if you don't mind, I just caught your nice looking bracelet there. Do you want to show off with some of your, grandbabies? Or?
It's our whole family. My daughter always gave this to me, and she has each of the grand girls. We have four granddaughters, and they had that. They had my husband and I pictures. So, I really treasure it.
Do you mind holding it up real quick to that camera to show them off and
okay.
Say hi
it's
to everybody?
It's getting a little outdated. Let's see. Where can I?
There you go.
Is that it?
Perfect.
Yeah.
I love it.
I do, too. I do.
Thank you for being
it's
here.
It's with me a lot of the time.
I can tell you're. I notice it in the rest. You're wearing it with pride. So
okay.
Thanks for being here, Corey.
We
appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
Thank
nice
you.
To meet you. Yeah, thanks for being here. All right, stick around. We got a lot more coming up right after this.